वेरी हैप्पी संडे टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडेज वीडियो विल डिस्कस द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो विच वी हैड डन ऑन द कॉलम पोजिशनिंग। सो आई विल गिव यू द लिंक्स ऑफ यू नो द वीडियोज, यू नो दिस द वीडियो वन लिंक, आई विल एड इट इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन सो दैट यू कैन ऑल्सो रिलेट टू इट। सो वी हैड डन द कॉलम पोजिशनिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्लान, एंड नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग विच वी वॉन्ट टू डू ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्लान इज वी वॉन्ट टू डू द स्ट्रक्चर ड्राॅइंग इन द टेक्ला स्ट्रक्चर डिजाइनर। सो बिफोर दैट लेट अस ओपन द यू नो कैड फाइल ऑफ दिस एंड विल व्यू द कैड फाइल एंड विल सी। सो दिस इज द पर्टिकुलर यू नो ड्राॅइंग विच वी आर हैविंग हियर। एंड नाउ वॉट यू वॉन्ट इज वी ऑलरेडी हैव डन द कॉलम पोजिशनिंग एंड आफ्टर वी हैव डन द कॉलम पोजिशनिंग वी वॉन्ट टू you know include the center line diagram so that we can execute and import the drawing in the Tekla structural. So I have already made the you know files, as you can see here. So we have made the center line diagram, and as well as this unit is in mm here. We converted the units into mm, and this particular center line, so you have put it in a separate layer, and you know you have made this as the DXF file. So simply we have you know just drawn a center line along it, put it in a separate layer of metric, and then converted it into mm. So if you want to know how to convert the feed file into mm, you can find out in our YouTube channel. Also the link for that particular video also, if you're converting you know your feed file into mm file, that particular link also I'll give it in the video description for all of you. Okay, so now once this is done, we'll just import it, and while importing also we'll face a unique problem here in the Tekla structural designer, and we'll solve that particular problem also. Okay, so let's go, and we have this particular interface of the Tekla structural designer, and we'll just click on new, and the new file will open. Depends upon your system how much time it will take. So let's go to model and go to construction levels, and we'll create our construction levels here. So this is a foundation level, let's give it minus 1.2 meters. This is a plinth level, and the other floor levels will give this as the 3.2 meters, the floor to floor height, and we'll give SSL of a slab thickness of 100 mm, and then click on. So this is G plus 1 and G plus 2. This is the other floors which we need to make, and then we'll click on OK. So first of all, we'll go and check our settings here. So we'll change the settings here to India settings, because we want to design it by Indian code and make this effective. And then click on OK. The model settings also, we'll just change it to India. Earlier I had made a model in the UK code, so that's why we need to change this. So now we can proceed ahead, go to model and just check the column whether it's, if it will be the UK code, then it will be C25 like that, but that is Indian code is now you know changed. So like this also you can change the codes. So okay, so we'll go to the model here, and in the base level we'll just go and import the CAD files which we have just you know. So this is the ground floor DXF file, so we'll just import the DXF file. Just click on it. I want the center line, the units will be in mm, and then click on next bilayer, and it will be imported in all the levels. Click on finish. So this is it, and just click on escape. So this in blue it's visible, the grid lines. So I'll go again and just click on this ground floor once again. This time we'll need we don't need the center line, we only need to import it as a shadow. So we'll just zoom in. So this is the part which you are observing, and this is actually lies in the zone 3. So we'll use the, and 4 inch wall are being used, so 9 inch or the 230 mm columns are sufficient for this. Now what will happen, we'll just go to the next floor and go to levels here and go to this next floor, and we'll import the center line is already imported here for the one, but if you don't want you can delete it. Or else what we can do while importing it, we'll just press Ctrl plus D, and while importing this grid line ground floor DXF, we can only do on the center line, and as a particular architectural grid mm next, and only in these two layers bottom two layers. Click on finish, and after that just go to import DXF and grant ground floor and click on OK, and don't take the center line, click on the shadow, click on MM, click on finish. So this is the ground floor plan which you are having, and then I'll go to the first floor. Also we'll just import the DXF file, import DXF, and you will just go and click on this first floor and import this DXF file. So one thing we'll notice here, so import the center line in the unit is in mm, and then click on next, and only in this particular level let's keep it, and then click on finish. So yeah, once you do that, you will observe, suppose we are placing a column here, I'm just showing you by purpose, if there's quite some error like this, you know, emerges. I placed a column in the ground floor, suppose say I placed it at the center, Ctrl plus Z, emptying the column, and suppose I placed the column at the center here, turn off the automatic alignment, now it will be at the center. Suppose this column is at the center, now as you can see, this is not at the center here. So this is at a particular distance here. If you want to measure the distance here with the help of this dimension arrow, we'll not be able to do that, but we might be you know, able to, you know, achieve a particular you know. So for that we can check the difference. For that we'll just go and import DXF and import the ground floor DXF file, and the just import the only the center line, and as a shadow, sorry, as an artificial grid in this layer, in this particular layer, click on finish. Now we'll have two grids here. Just delete the column, and straight away we can see the difference. Can measure the distance between these two. So it is 0.231. So our grid line, you know, is just away from its target by 0.231. So in this direction, that is, if you just see the coordinate system here, this coordinate system, if you see from the top view, so in the minus y direction, if you just go 0.231, then we should be okay with it. Okay, so if we can easily do it. So here in the edit option, we have an option of move DXF shadow. So here when you click this, as you can see, this doesn't work. So for that, we'll just click Ctrl plus Z, and then delete everything. And after that, we'll just go back to the first floor. And this time, when we'll import the DXF file of the first floor, and we will just import the particular center line in mm. And this time, when you import, sorry, we just missed a step. Again, I'll do ink again. So import DXF, first floor DXF, select the first floor and only the center line. This time when you import, you'll have this offset of minus y, minus, this is in meter, mm will do, but this unit, they take, tekla takes in meter, so you have to notice that. So it will be, it was minus 0.231 exactly. Then click on next. And then all the layers from the starting from the first floor. Click on finish. Here we'll just import the DXF once again, first floor, and this time as a shadow, mm, and offset of in the minus y direction 0.231. Click on finish. So now we can see the DXF has been imported. So now let us check whether our columns are properly done or not. You can just give a column here, you can just turn off the automatic alignment, so place it at the center and go to this view and check. So it's exactly at the center now. So like this we can check, Ctrl plus Z. So like this thing intentionally I have provided, because while I was making the plan, I had faced this problem, and I had tried many things like aligning the DXF file and not, but it didn't work. So in that case, you can follow this method to just import the DXF file and you know avoid the mismatch by using this method if this problem ever arises. Hope it will help you. So okay, now after having said that, we have a separate floor plan for your ground floor as well as first floor, and we have the column positions and we have the center line. So what else do you need? We just need to make the structural members now. So for making the structural members, we'll simply go and take our columns first. So here we are going to use column sizes of 230 into 230. So these two columns, since this particular span is large, we will provide 300 into 230 here. So we'll go here and we'll just select this and go to new edit. This will have our 300 into 230. So this will be our orientation, and we'll just take here this thing. I will just save this particular thing. So let it be my let's say C1 230 cross 300, and just click on OK. So we'll take this C1, or else we can define the other sizes which we want. So okay, let's define the other size as, let's take this and we'll make some changes here. We'll do this as 230 into 230. Okay, and we'll save this as C2 230 cross 230. And another one, we will have the same size, but we'll have we can change the orientation of it. So let's place the columns which you want 230 into 300 first. So we'll place it. First one, let's place it here, and second one, we'll place it here. And this particular column, let's provide 230 into 230 here. And later, if this doesn't pass, then we'll check. And we remain with these three. Here also we'll provide 230 into 230. And for these two, span is large, we'll provide the first one 300 into 230. But we can, change the orientation of this. So I'll just check briefly, very briefly, I'll check, measure this distance. It is around 4.069. And this particular distance is 3.278. So, but if you check this distance and this distance, then this is. So we have to decide the orientation of it, but for starting, let's go with the 90 degree orientation for these two. If this comes, more reinforcement comes, we can change this. So select this and give it a rotation of 90 degrees. So the orientation will be like this now. So for the next set of columns, now in the next set of columns, we'll just do this. We take columns here and then select here 230 into 300 and select apply in this and this. So here, as you can check, this space is definitely less than this space. So we'll change the orientation of this, select this 2 and 3, and they change the orientation to, here you'll have the rotation to like this. And for these three, I think we can give 230 to 230 column. So I'm just giving it based on my experience, but here starting, if you have to give 230 columns, starting and provide 230 in all, and after that also we can change that. As you can see in the earlier videos, I always take a base size and then provide all the columns, and after that I decide after design that what size we need to give. But for here I made a little bit of exception. So after that, click on escape and go to structure 3D and just open the 3D view. Click on any corner and right click of your using the right click option of your mouse, you can rotate it and see the columns. And it's a good practice to validate it also, so that you could see that every design is done properly. So after validating it, and we'll just click on this minimize button, and then we need to make go to the plinth level, and plinth level will just apply the beams. So I selected the beams here, and here I will just go for a size of our beam here. So let's go for the size of, so we'll go the size of 230 into 300. So we'll go here, the size will be 230 cross 300. Okay, and select like this. We'll do the secondary beams first, and we'll check whether there is any other secondary beam. I think we have covered all. So both this column doesn't have a, you know, column to column connection. Just double click. Releases, make them both as pinned. Here also no column to column connection. Releases, make them as pinned. And now for the main beams. Okay, we have a secondary beam here as well. Go to the beam here and add the beam here, and make, go to the releases, make this as pinned, and go to the beam here and take the particular set, or we've not even saved it, so we'll save it now. 230 to 300, we'll just save it. We can save it B or PB 230 cross 300. We'll just apply. Left click with the left to drag and apply. This option will work for all the primary beams. So like this is our plinth level layout beam column which you have made. Now let's go for the top floor. Top floor also, it is the same. Before going to the top floor, we will just check, go to validate and check whether there is a member intersection error. So there is no member intersection or member collision error. We'll go to the first floor. So now the first floor also, I'll just go and select this particular beam, and we'll select here this option, and we'll just change the, you know, depth to your 350, and then click on OK. And after that, just click on this beam again, and then take. Okay, I've just not saved it, so we'll save this as B1 230 cross 350. Click on OK. And now we'll take this particular beam of 350 size, and we are good to go here. So here we can provide hidden beams later, but for the remaining main spans, we'll just do all the things which we need to do. Suppose this is a, we'll give a beam here, for example, and another beam we can give here. Secondary beams we are doing, mind you, we can give here, I think, there we can give a secondary beam. The remaining, I think, we can give conceal beam for these two, so we'll not model that. And the remaining things, I think we can go for the primary beams. Cantilever also, this is a very small cantilever. We can, if you can want to design, you can do it. Otherwise, you can just give a conceal beam here and extend the beams which I have taken here. So I'll not provide it now. And okay, this again, we have a secondary beam here, like this. Any other secondary beams? I don't think so. We have missed any secondary beams. So for now, we'll just do both of these as your pinned, because no column to column connection. Go to releases, go to this as pinned and pinned. Okay, here also we'll go to releases and take this as pinned and also as pinned. And here also we'll go to this option, go to releases, take this as pinned and as pinned. Okay. Here also, now here the end one is pinned and two is fixed, because end one doesn't have any column to column, pin to column connection, and end one is the bottom one. So end one is pinned and end two is fixed, bottom to top, left to right. That's how we fixed end one and end two. So after that we'll go to beam here, and again just 213 to 350. Just do this. Try to place the columns here, beams here. So after that, taking this, we'll just go here and just apply all the beams. The process of the software is pretty fast, and if you're watching the video for the first time, you can subscribe to our channel. There are a lot of videos related to this topic which you'll find here. So main beams will join because that gives more strength to the structure. Here, as you can see, so this is the particular arrangement of the next level, and we can also add the slabs here. Apart from the staircase portion, we can add the slabs in all the directions. So for the knowing the staircase position is also very important here. We'll just go to this any ground floor central. This is the position of the staircase, so we'll place the in all the positions apart from the staircase. So like if you want to provide one way slabs also in this case, suppose this in this two, you want to provide one way slabs also, you can also do that. So for example, you just take the slabs, and you'll just have to take a new slab, and this decomposition will just make as one way, and here you can place it like this. After that, you can select, and you can just give the rotation angle of 90, and then if you see, this is the perfect symbol for the one way slab also. So like this, you can just have this structure. As you can see, structure has been designed. Now after the structure has been designed, you can just go to model construction levels, and then you can copy this particular level from, let's say, 1 and also from 1. And after that, you can click on your OK. So after you click on OK, you'll go back to the construction levels and make them back as unique. So once this is done, the next thing is to apply the loads. So you quickly apply the load for the dead load for the wall, load of the walls. Go to dead, go to load here, go to fully UDL, and just take a dead load of, let's say, here we need to give the load for the external walls. So since these are 4-inch walls which we are having here, so we'll provide a load of, so for the 4-inch wall we'll provide a load of 5.7 everywhere. If you want to know how to calculate this load, you can see our videos, or else you can ask in the comment section. I'll give you the link to that particular video. So now we'll just go to the full UDL, and we'll go here 5.7 and apply dead loads will be applied here at the base. So these are applied. Here like this, and you can go to structure 3D and check the dead load here. Okay, let's validate it once if there is no error. Okay, there is no error. We'll go to the next floor, go to structure 1. And here we'll just go here dead load, and we'll go full UDL, and we'll apply the dead load here as well, the same process. And go to the scene content. Okay, now just select this imposed load from here, and go to the load and level load. So for residential building, as per IS 875 table number 1, residential part 2 table number 1, load of 2 kN per meter square. You have applied dead load and this is the imposed load. So after that we can copy this load to next level. This is the loading. Go to model and then click on escape and also validate the model. And after that go to construction levels and this two source of two, make this as one. Click on OK. This has been copied. Go to construction levels, make this back as unique and just click on OK. And after again go back to construction level and check whether the sources are OK or not. And after that we'll apply the loads in the next level. So first let's apply the imposed loads here from here itself, and then we'll go here level load of 2, apply it here, and then we'll go to the terrace level. We're going to the terrace level, go to structure window and then go to the topmost level, and here just select the dead load and the 5.7 dead load. I'll go full UDL and 5.7, we can apply it here in the parapet, sorry, in the walls around the staircase. And for the remaining walls we'll apply a load of 2, which is for our parapet walls, or the, you can say, along the perimeter of our particular here we'll have the parapet wall here in the cantilever, so I'm not providing here. So this is the loading which we are having. And you go to check the structure 3D. So this is the load here, dead load as well as the imposed load. So these two loading you are having here, and remaining loads are the wind load. So if you just measure this particular building above your ground floor, it is around 9.5 meters. So as per IS 875 part 3, which is the Indian code for the wind load, for buildings less than 10 meter height, wind load is not required. And also for the seismic load, which is also a different kind of your horizontal load, the as per IS 13920, the code for detailing, the load, seismic load, is not critical for buildings up to 5 stories height, G+4 or 5 stories height. So that's why we will not provide seismic load also here, so that you can go for an economical design for the zone 3. So here, but you can provide it, but the code has not said that you cannot provide. You can provide, but it's not critical, that's what it said. So in some of the designs which you think that we should provide it, like in especially in zone 4 and zone 5, always you consider seismic load. And in zone 3 also, for important buildings, we can consider seismic load just for an additional factor of safety. Okay, so now we'll just go here and just go to this load, and we have the load combinations. And as per the load combination, we'll define a combination, we'll go to generate, and this is operating factor is selected. Limit state methods are selected here. In the Indian codes, we have limit state method and working stress method. I'll make a video on this too, what is the difference between them, and click on next, and then finish. And after that, click on OK. So now, after having applied the load combinations, the dead load and the live load, we can design the model. For that, you can go to design and then just simply click on this design on static, and after that your building will be designed. So we'll keep the video for now, it is too long the video. And for more such videos, subscribe to our channel, and if you are liking our video, then make sure you hit the like button, it really helps us a lot. So see you guys, keep learning.